So hey guys, welcome back to my YouTube channel. And today I am back with a new story, not with a new rule or new concept or new theory, but with a new story. And I thank you for showing so much love and support for the needle story. I got many positive feedback from it. Thank you so much that you liked it. And today's story is also very interesting and very thoughtful. So it will make you think in a very different perspective, and I'm pretty sure that you will love it. So I wanted to adjust the camera angle, but it's okay. So I hope, let's start with the story. So listen very carefully and try to apply it in your real life, okay? So let's start. Once upon a time, there was a man who was very frustrated in his life. He was utterly frustrated because of many reasons. So, out of frustration, he came to a wise man, to a sadhu, and he told the sadhu, "I am very frustrated in my life because to whomsoever I ask a question, for example, what is happiness, what is religion, what is inner peace, what is peace, what is life, what is the purpose of life, everyone gave a different answer. To whichever person I asked this question, what is the purpose of life, what is mean by peace, what is mean by happiness, what is mean by anything, you name it, anything, each of them is giving me a different answer. Even if I ask anyone, what is God, who is God, everyone is giving me a different answer. And that has made me so frustrated because there is no one single answer." So the wise man, the sadhu, listened very carefully and very silently, and then he took the man to a place where the sadhu called an elephant and four blind men. Okay, man or men, four blind men. And what the sadhu did was, he told the first blind man to touch the trunk of the elephant. He told the second blind man to touch the ears of the elephant. He told the third blind man to touch the tail of the elephant. And he told the fourth blind man to touch the foot of the elephant. So after 5 minutes of time, 5 minutes, he told the blind man that what the thing that you are touching now is called as elephant. So the blind man tried to touch every area of the part they were assigned, and after 5 more minutes, the wise man called all the four blind men back. So he asked the first blind man, "What is an elephant?" So the first blind man said, "The elephant is like a pillar. It is so huge and so strong. This blind man has been given the legs of the elephant." He asked the second blind man, how can you define an elephant?" He said, "The elephant is very soft," because the second blind man had given the ears of the elephant. The third blind man said, "The elephant tail, to whom the tail has been given," he said, "The elephant is like a horse. It is very hairy," because he was touching the tail. And the fourth blind man was touching the trunk, said, "The elephant is very elastic, flexible, and very soft." So upon hearing the four responses, all the blind men started fighting within themselves, arguing that this is the right answer, this is the right answer. Everyone started fighting. And this was the point where the wise man brought the frustrated man and showed him what was going on. And then a huge enlightenment came across the frustrated man, because he understood each one was having a different opinion about the same thing, because they were experiencing a different part. The one who was experiencing the legs told that the elephant is strong, but one who was experiencing the ears told that the elephant was soft. So you see, in life we can apply this story, we can apply the moral of this story in our daily life, as we see that everyone we ask, what is happiness, what is this, what is that, what is God, what is religion, each of them is giving a very different answer. If you ask me, if you ask some another person, we might give different answers and you might think which one is the right. So to know the right answer, it is you who need to think, who need to analyze and know what you think happiness is. So if you really think on such deep questions on by your own, you will really find many such answers to the questions which people have many different opinions on. You can apply this to know what is God. Just what do you feel about God? What do you feel about happiness? According to you, how you define the terms is the definition for you. You don't need to ask it to me, to any other person, what is this, what is that. Just sit quietly, meditate, and you'll get all of your answers. So this was a very short story, but I hope this will make a big impact in your life if you apply it carefully. So see you in the next video. I hope you'll like this story. Please do share, like, and subscribe the channel. And thank you for supporting all the previous videos. I'm very grateful for that. So see you in the next video. Till then, wish you lots of luck, positivity, and good wishes from my side. This is Apart by Ved. Thank you.